Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to composite this Action VFX Dirt Blast stock footage into a shot in HitFilm Express. So I've already created the project file, and I'm basically just going to walk you through this project file. The first thing I needed was some background footage. This is actually some old footage that I shot of Garden of the Gods in Colorado Springs, Colorado. There's people walking around back there and everything, so you kind of have to just ignore the fact that they're actually back there. Had there actually been a real explosion here, I'm sure it would have caused a lot more commotion, right? So the first thing I did was I found the dirt blast footage that I wanted to find, and that dirt blast footage actually is Dirt Blast 2, which you can find on the website for Action VFX. Link is in the description below, but basically if you go to the site, just click below and find it, then you can go to explosions and dirt blasts, and you can purchase the entire collection. It's only $75. But basically I use this one right here, Dirt Blast 2. You could just purchase that one for $15 if you like, or you can use any other sort of blast footage. Other things that I use since I'm here, let me just go ahead and round it out. I am using a dust wave from the Dust Wave collections. I am also using a burn mark from the burn mark texture. And last but not least, I am using a sound effect from their sound effects collection. And all of those are actually free to be used. I'm just using some explosion sound effect. All of those are free to be used, except for the actual dirt blast itself. So the dirt blast I just placed right here, and any dirt blast that you use has actually this big ground in front of it, so it needs to be masked out. And if you look at my masking job here, you can see that I just sort of masked around it, so that way that the rest of it is basically gone. Notice that I masked around this rock here too. But you don't have to show, I showed a little bit of the ground like it was sort of part of the scene. But if I wanted to, I could back this off. This is somewhat feathered as well. So that way, you know, it sort of masks in, behind everything, and it looks like it belongs there. I masked it out, which means that of course I had to invert it, right? Invert the mask to make sure. Now the dust wave I composited right on top of that. Again, you will need to mask that. Otherwise, there's a big line that goes across. Okay. And because the dust wave actually came around in front of the rock and I didn't really want it to, I went ahead and duplicated the background shot. And then I simply masked out the rock here. And so now you can see that when I turn that on, that particular layer on, it looks like the dust wave goes behind that rock, but really it's just that same footage mask. Now the whole thing, the whole background shot has been locked down, and you will see that I added a grade layer with a big shake effect on it, and the shake effect itself was 100, and it drops down after 1 second to zero. Speed was set at 1.5, and everything else was left the same at 50 and 100 for smooth and scale, respectively, right? So that allows that big shake to happen when the explosion occurs, and I only put that grade layer where the explosion itself was, right? The only other thing that I added on this, actually two things. One is I added a burn mark to it all. So if I were to just take these out for a second, you can see the burn mark there. That burn mark is basically kind of squished down. So you can see that it has been resized to fit in the area where that is. That burn mark does actually appear there, right? After the blast happens. And the burn mark is actually set to a blend mode of overlay, so it sort of mixes in with the grass. Now, I could have left it as normal, and it probably would have looked fine, but I just thought I kind of liked the look of that overlay where the burn is sort of masked. I might even have, if I had spent more time on it, maybe I would have had a few different layers of burn marks here, you know, to really sell that there were several different effects on that, right? The last thing I added besides that was the shadow of the dirt blast, which is here, you can see, and it could be maybe a little bit darker to match here, but you know, figuring that this is mostly smoke and stuff, I went ahead and made it pretty light. Basically what it is it's a copy of the dirt blast, except it has been flipped upside down and squished really, short. And then to it, I added a brightness contrast effect, and I took the brightness all the way down to negative 100%, and then I just changed the opacity. It's only at 17%. If I went all the way up, you could see how dark that would be. But the cool thing about that is as the explosion happens, the shadow of the explosion happens as well. So, you know, I might actually work on matching it towards this shadow or something like that. But given that it was a lot of smoke and stuff, I went ahead and left it pretty low, just enough where there was a shadow, but not so much that it, you know, sort of overwhelmed the whole shot and made it sort of look fake. And when we were done, I had something that looked like this. And you might want to spend some time color grading or, you know, getting these different composites to match each other so that they all tie together as well. And pretty much in a nutshell, that's how I created the explosion effect here in the Garden of the Gods in Colorado Springs, Colorado. If you have any questions about how that works, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.